Houston Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening aboard the ISS. I'm Josh Byerly. More CubeSats were deployed off the side of the station this week. 16 were released earlier this month, and 12 more were deployed in this second batch. These small Earth imaging satellites will provide clearer pictures of our home planet for researchers and educators. One of the great mysteries that the station is helping solve has to do with plants. It's a Japanese experiment called Aniso, and it's designed to figure out how plants automatically know how thick their stems need to be in order to overcome gravity. A lot of the plant's energy goes into overcoming gravity, so this experiment could lead to better ways to grow things here on Earth and on future space flights. The crew is also getting geared up for the arrival of the next SpaceX Dragon vehicle. They've been practicing on the station's robotic arm, which they'll use to reach out and grab Dragon once it arrives.
This is the control station, and what you see over here on my left, this controls the translation of the robotic arm. And then over here we have rotational control. And in this middle computer is where we actually take the robotic arm into the different modes that we do have.
The current Dragon launch date is set for March 16th with a rendezvous with the station planned for March 18th. This week's social media question is, how does the OPALS experiment work that is going up on the next Dragon flight? Well, OPALS is a way to test out better communication with the space station using lasers. And of course, lasers are always cool. Currently, NASA's communication satellites use radio waves to send information from space to the ground. But lasers could allow us to transmit stronger signals with more data. So OPALS will test a way to do this from the station. Make sure to keep sending us your questions and comments using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week